Good morning. It is 9:36. It's September. Oh my God. Hello. I don't think y'all understand. Like, first of all, I did not want to wake up this morning. It's Saturday. I'm tired. I'm so tired, and I've been tired all day. And yesterday, I did not post on TikTok for my daily post on TikTok, and I'm mad at myself about that, because it's just like, what are you doing, you know? What are you doing? Like, so, I have to do 2 posts today. We're gonna see how that work out for me though. I don't have no brushes over here. None. I need to wash my brushes. I got a makeup appointment Monday. I have to go do my cousin makeup Monday. So that's another thing that I need to be trying to focus on and worry about. I gotta go get her some foundation and concealer, because she's light bright. She's a light bright girl. So yeah, but they rushing me. They didn't even wake me up this morning to get dressed or anything. So, and they know I take the longest. So can't nobody be mad. Can't nobody be mad at me. I don't care, honestly. The lunch ain't gonna happen when the lunch ain't happen. And decency and in order. Cause, then I had to wear, do my natural hair this morning. So that really would took all my time. If I would just woke up, wash my face, brush my teeth, and did my, what's it called? And did my makeup, I would be ready to go by now, but I had to do my hair. And since I got my natural hair out, you gotta look like something. It can't just be what it be being. But yesterday I was just so tired. We was running around doing our table yesterday. When I tell you, God just be working. My stain is bothering me. God just be working. He be working because our table was not together at first. We had went out, got a few little things to make it look like something. And it came together. Surprisingly, it came together. Now I'm getting my stuff together. Leave out. But I didn't even tell y'all what's going on. So today is our women's luncheon at church. What they did is they asked everybody to make their own table. This table was supposed to represent a scripture that you picked. For the luncheon, so your group of people will sit at your table for the luncheon. So yeah, everybody had different scriptures, different themes for their tables. I will show y'all when I get there what the tables are looking like, because some of the tables are really creative. Our table was very last minute, I'm not gonna lie. Sorry, I'm trying to put this glue on these lashes so I can put them on. But yeah, our table was very last minute. Like, we did it yesterday. And me, I really didn't know the assignment for the tables, just because my older 2 sisters, like, were over our table. So I didn't know what we were supposed to do for real. I didn't know the assignment because I didn't go to the meeting that they had. for the tables. So, of course, I ain't know what was going on. But, you know, when there's a wheel, there's a way. Come on, face. I need you to dry. This fan is dying on me. But, yeah, when there's a wheel, there's a way. So, we made a way for our table to look like something. Is it the best one? Probably not. And it's like a contest. So, whoever the judges pick as the best table wins. I don't know what exactly they win, but they just win, I guess. I don't think it's a prize for real. But, yeah, that's where we're going. That's where we're headed out to. If I ever get ready in time. I have no idea what I'm putting on. They saying just wear anything, but I don't have anything just to wear. So it's kind of hard to just wear anything. I'm trying to see what these have look like. Because I just had a little sleep back like that. Okay, period. Look like something. Look like something because, ooh, I need to lay this edge down. Alright, y'all. I'm finna go ahead and get dressed real quick. Try to find something to put on and then we can head out. Alright, you guys. I'm here. My face looks so weird to me.
Sing. Go tell Selena to sing.
You capturing pictures?
No.
Oh.
Please. I'm doing my vlog. Y'all, these are my sisters. We're in the media booth. It's happening here though. I pulled up, I said, where did all these cars come from?
I know.
Those people
y'all was talking about me and y'all be here sinning.
I know.
Go get it.
So this is what I decided to put together. Okay, sleep back. White puffer, puff shoulder, and then this skirt that you just skirt in, and some silver heels. Super cute. So we. Everybody finna head back to the back where the tables are. So I will take y'all with me to the back. Let me take some lighting. I'll take y'all with me and showcase the back. I am gonna start taking pictures as well, so I'll be multitasking.
Jarvis, say hey.
It's on. Just go back there and do what you gotta do.
So y'all, we headed to the back. I was waiting on my sisters because this is our table and they over here walking slow still in the booth doing nothing. This our table, y'all. How cute.
I forgot to tell y'all my nail broke. The third one.
Is table number 10.
Forsake you, just like the woman, she may not have had much to offer, but what she had, she may not have been perfect. She was called a sinner. Had something precious to give Jesus. I began placing a very long time ago poster boards up in my house. The ladies of Bethlehem have heard this testimony. Placing poster boards up in my house with the word of God. So where I turn, I get to throw it today, y'all. I don't have short hair today, I got long. I get to throw it today. The word of God, so everywhere I will turn, I was spending time with God and in his word. That's what I had to do. I even placed word in the bathroom because that's where I was spending time in. I put word in my car because that's where I was spending time with. I even put word on my So he was speaking to me, and guess what? I was speaking to myself. You are the head and not the tail. Somebody needs to hear that. You are blessed coming, and you are blessed going. You are blessed in the city, and you are blessed in the field. You are, and put your name on it, Tony, you are more than a conqueror. No weapon formed against you. I put the word on it. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. They may form minister, but they won't prosper. You got to stand on the word of God. Stand on the faith and know, hey. Though some may not receive and even reject the authenticity of the oil in your alabaster box, be not discouraged, women. Be not dismayed, ladies. Jesus was rejected. Jesus was despised. It cost too much for me not to turn around. It cost too much for me to go back for the yesteryears. It cost too much. The weight that I carried was heavy. It cost too much for me to go back. I love Psalms 23. It says, yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, put your name on it, fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thou rod, thou staff, thou comfort me, thou preparest a table.
From Luke chapter 7, verse 38. And I would like to start at verse 37, reading the New King James Version. And it says, and behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus sat at the table in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil and stood at the feet behind him, weeping. And she began to wash his feet with her tears and wiped them with the hair of her head. She kissed his feet and anointed them with the fragrant oil. Let us pray. And went down dead-end roads, made some wrong choices, and still haven't forgiven yourself. Some may need to forgive, and some of us just might need to be forgiven. Some sisters are walking in fear, disbelief, doubt, anxiety, pain, molestation, grief, loneliness, brokenness, and guilt. Is there a remedy? If so, what can we do to make this roller coaster of life come to an end? Give your it to Jesus, because he's the one who can handle it. Your problems, your pains, Jesus can handle it. Your fears, your disbeliefs, your struggles, your depression, your loneliness, your insecurities, your anxiety, that time of molestation, Jesus can handle it. Even that time when you told him no, but he still did a yes. Jesus can handle it. In this story in Luke, a woman, she has no name. Put your name in. She hears about Jesus. She just heard that he was having dinner at a Pharisee's home. She didn't have an invitation. She didn't get a call to say, hey, come over for dinner. Jesus coming.
Right.
She didn't get no invitation. But she had a need. A need that the doctors couldn't diagnose. A need that the therapist couldn't resolve. She knew only Jesus could change it, could shift it, could deliver her life from her it. May I suggest to you that you intensify your worship unto God. Intensify means make it stronger. So if you were going giving God a little pity pat just because you want to get through this 1 hour and a half on Sunday morning, I encourage you. Matter of fact, I double dog dare you. In the morning, when you walk into your house of worship, you put your worship on fleek. Make it strong. Do like the daughters like David said. Oh, you thought that was something? Wait till the next time. Hey. I was like, did you see Sister So-and-so this morning at the altar? She must be going through something. Let them say what they need to say. But you're trying to get to Jesus, the one who's going to make you whole.
If it's a debtor and that creditor forgives 500 denaro versus 50 denaro, who is going to love me more? Simon, well, I guess the one who you forgave more. You right? That person is more aware of who I am. That person knows what all they've been through to get to where they are. And you know, sometimes it's that way with church folks. I'm sorry. Some people feel like they've been holy and righteous their whole lives. They feel like I've just already all up here. And they come to church and they go into worship and they don't even know how to just give to God. To just let go and praise and worship God. But those people who God had delivered from a whole lot, he delivered them from whole money. With their whole heart. And that's what she did here. She ran up to God with her whole heart. But I love how God, Jesus here, he redirects Simon. He said, let's put the focus on you. You invited me here. Didn't you invite me to come here? Just like we invite Jesus into our churches. We said, come into our church, come into our home, come into our lives. He's like, you invited me here. And I accepted the invitation. I'm here. But what have you done? See, it was customary in the biblical times when you showed up to someone's house and you've been invited, that you first gonna give them some water to wash their feet because they wore sandals and it was dusty, right? So you would give them some water to wash their feet. He was like, you didn't give me no water to wash my feet. But she washed my feet with her tears. Tears of gratitude. And then Jesus said to him, well, wait a minute. Not only did you not wash my, give me water to wash my feet, you didn't give me a kiss. They used to greet each other with a holy kiss. But this man who invited him didn't even give him a holy kiss. He was like, but this woman who pressed her way into here, she didn't even invite me into her house. She pressed her way to be in my presence because she knew the power of my presence. When she got here, she kissed my feet. Hallelujah. But then he said, it don't just stop right there, right? He said, she hasn't ceased to kiss my feet since the time I came in. And then she took that which was most valuable to her. And she anointed my feet. Normally, he said, now look, I came in. You didn't anoint my head with oil. Yep. That was another customary thing back in biblical times. You invite somebody to your house, especially a man who's a prophet of God. You're supposed to anoint his head with oil. But this Pharisee who invited him had done none of those things. And I hear God saying to us today, now see this woman, she gave everything she had to God. She was willing to give everything to God. You know why? Because she knew who he was. And you know what I submit to Simon? Now, Simon ain't here. But I said the same way Simon was saying Jesus, if he was a prophet, he would know who this woman was. I said, Simon, if you knew who Jesus was, the person in your presence, you would have done the same thing and even more in this woman. And that's how it is for us today. If you know him, if you know who he is, no one should have to beg and plead with you to praise and worship God.
Alright y'all, I'm at church and I'm finna get ready to actually practice so I can perform in a few. Church go by so fast, girl, you would think, oh, I got forever to practice. No, you really don't. So I'm just gonna get me one good practice in, no distractions, just me and God. Pray over myself and just ask him to use me for whatever message that anyone needs to hear, not to crowd. So yeah, I'm in my uniform. This is what I'm wearing. Let me see if I can put y'all up somewhere. Okay, this one I have on. I'm sorry, it's dark in here. I turned the lights on so I can have some personal time with God. But this is what I have on to dance in. I'm really nervous, and I don't think no one knows that I'm nervous, just because like I've danced before plenty of times, like honestly, but I never danced by myself, like no backup dancers, no nothing. So it's just me and God up there, and I know I got it, but it's like I really wanted to display the message in the song as well as just display the message to anyone that needs to hear it, or needs it in any way, shape, or form. So yeah, I'm in my white and orange for Women's Day. Thank y'all for tuning in to my first performance. I'm excited and nervous at the same time, but you know, God gonna make a way out of no way. So I'm finna practice and I will talk to y'all when, well, y'all probably see me perform, so. Okay, you guys, so I'm back home from church. This is what I wore to church. It's a pretty dress I bought yesterday. But my performance, well, my dance went great. A lot of people enjoyed it. I even reached out to a little girl to make her want to dance, so I'm happy. But yeah, I need to clean my room. Like, the aftermath of getting dressed, it's crazy. It's crazy, but you know, we're gonna get it right. We're gonna get it together. I gotta wash makeup brushes. I have a makeup appointment. I have to do my cousin makeup tomorrow. So I think I'm gonna continue the weekend vlog until tomorrow, because I really didn't record anything for this weekend, because I was supposed to start it on Thursday, but I totally forgot. I don't know what I was thinking. So I'm going to do it for a longer period, probably until Tuesday. Hopefully the one from last weekend go up today, I'm gonna try to get that editing out. My nail broke, y'all. I don't know if I told y'all that, but the nail broke ghetto, but you know, whatever. But yeah, okay, I guess let me get to cleaning. I really don't want to, y'all. Deep clean my room yesterday, and to come back to a dirty room just was not my plan for today. Not at all. Okay. I look so pretty. We be wearing the outside of that young jammies. Okay, for real. Let me clean up. Alright, y'all, so it's been a couple, like an hour later probably. I had to take my sister home, her and my nephews. And now I'm finna get, now I'm about to eat my Popeyes because I had stopped by some stores. Hold on. Okay, so that don't be irritating me. I had to stop by some stores, get a few things. Now I'm back at home. About to eat because my head is like thump. It's thumping, you know what I'm saying? It's going through it for real because I ain't even eat breakfast this morning. So my head is going cuckoo crazy right now. So I'm finna eat and then I'm going to edit. We'll finish editing so that I can have this video go up today. Okay. And I really need no games. Yeah. Need to. Hold on. Sorry, I'm all over the place, but your girl got a lot going on, a lot of things that she want to get done before the end of the day, before it's dark outside. So I'm trying to get to it. But I just want to check in and tell y'all, hey, I didn't talk to y'all after my performance because I was so tired. When I tell y'all how out of breath I was, I was coughing. It was too hot. I was sweating. My back was sweating. I'll see y'all in a few. Give y'all an update. And then probably more than likely I might see y'all tomorrow. But yeah. Good morning. I'm in the gym. Gonna get my workout in, y'all. But I just came on here to basically tell y'all. So I've been saying I've been bulking and I don't like that because it's not even winter time yet. So for me to already be bulking is poop. You know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to lean back out a lot. Not a little. A lot. Okay. I need to get down in my weight. I got down and then I went skyrocketing back up. That's not okay with me. I don't like that. So I'm finna see if I can get myself back down. Change the way I'm eating. I'm not eating out no more. Don't ask me to eat out. I'm not doing it. And even if I do eat out, I have to restrict myself on certain things. I've been eating cookies and ice cream just about every day with my sisters in them. That's why I don't like being at home. I have too many privileges. So I gotta cut that. But we gonna get into it. We gonna get the grind back going. Cause I'm not. And I got this new program. If y'all know Kate on TikTok, I love that girl. She don't know I'm a fan, but I'm a fan. So I got her workout program, the app. So I'm finna get into that. And yeah, let's get into it. I hope y'all can hear me because that TV is loud for no reason. So yeah. Bye.
might change the weather, and I promise forever.
To go do my cousin makeup, and my sister is my assistant for today. Say hey, assistant. Okay, girlies, so it is Tuesday, September the 12th. I'm finna head into Kroger. I just got done working out. I'm hot, sweaty, and I'm sweating. Okay, real bad. But I burned me a good amount of calories. Y'all know I told you I'm trying to get down in my weight. I'm trying to get it down. So I've been up in the gym burning calories like it's nothing at all. Yeah, we finna go into the store, get some fruits. I want some yogurt, probably some granola, things of that nature, just healthy things for me to eat. Because I really don't be eating breakfast because I don't be having nothing to eat. And then later on today, I think I'm gonna make me some salmon and stuff. So yeah, let's go into the store. This band is really tight on my head right now. But that lace is lacing, so we're gonna leave her on. Okay, we're gonna leave her on. But before I even get out, I need to put some lip gloss on. Let me tell y'all, this, what is this? This is the Ulta Beauty Juice Infused Lip Oil. I got the Kind Cherry. This one is so good. I think I had the apple one first, like the reddish one. This is like a purplish pink one, and it's so good. It works so well. It's $10, but it does what it needs to do. This, like, for other girls that are getting that Dior, I feel like this is like a good cheaper replacement at Ulta if y'all looking for one. So, get you one. get you one because I got mine. Okay, let's go in here. Because, yeah. Y'all think people gonna mind their business in Kroger or no? I feel like they should if they know like I know. Sun is like this way because my I only have one window in my room, so it's coming from over here, and this net in my room is killing me, like, for real. But it was raining outside, so I got a little sleepy. I got a little sleepy, girl. Okay, but I've been doing work, so yeah, that's so why I do that. Anyway, I've been doing work, so that's what your girl been having to go on. And I've been watching YouTube while I've been doing work because I got a few things I have to get done before the end of today. So yeah, and I will be in Skiggy next week on Wednesday. So I need to get myself mentally prepared for that. Cause I'm going to see all my old professors. I'm going to be getting questions asked. You know, the whole shebang of wang wang. Okay? And don't nobody really care. Like, we don't. But, yeah, computer set up. It's going to die. So I need to find a charger. Because if I don't, it's going to die. Then I'm going to be ish out of luck. Okay? I'm going to be ish out of luck. But y'all let me know if y'all like this setting. I feel like this setting, I can, like, it clears my skin better. It can make the, I can make the background darker or lighter. Yeah, I just feel like it's a better setting. And this is like the, what it is? The A something setting on the camera instead of like the video setting. If y'all have the Canon EOS M200, then you know what I'm talking about. If you don't, look it up. But yeah, I don't know, I just like to record on my camera because I just I'm so happy that I have a camera. Because when I get in and recording on that phone, it just wasn't giving the same effect. But I think I'm going to end the vlog here today. I think I'm gonna end it today. I don't know what I'm doing later on, probably nothing since it's like raining outside. It's sunny, but it's raining. So I'm really confused as to what's going on. But since it's doing that, I don't think I'm going to be going anywhere. After I get off work, probably just going to be right here. In this nice, so comfortable bed of mine. You know what I'm saying? That's what I might be doing. But I don't know yet. I want to go get another workout in, but I think I want to do an outside workout, so I need the rain to stop so I can do the outside workout, you know, because, like, yeah, I feel like me and my sister are walked, and after our walk, I'll probably do like some jump ropes and stuff like that before we go home. Or like our stopping period, because we're going to walk with my nephews and her kids. So we'll be having to take breaks because they got to go to the bathroom. They want to get out and walk. They want to do this, that, and third. They want to chase the rabbits and everything else that they be wanting to do. But yeah, I don't know where my lip will. Ed Boo, like, don't play with me. See? And then it just switched so much faster than the video recording. But I don't know. Is this my color? I guess this is my skin tone. I'm a little sus about that though. I think I'm a little darker. I got that melanin, huh? Let me get to work and I will talk to y'all later so we can end this weekend vlog and get to editing it, because it needs to be edited. But I hope y'all enjoyed. I think this weekend was probably like my favorite weekend just because I had so much to do, but everything was so, like, this weekend most definitely was my favorite weekend I've had yet. Like, just being in the space of women, being in the house of the Lord, being around godly women. Like, I'm around my sister and them, we're all godly women, but just being around other godly women that you do not know like that, or you don't see often, it was just good energy. I'm just gonna go ahead and end the vlog right here. I always end the vlogs looking crazy. But I hope you enjoyed this weekend vlog with your girl Destian. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, girly. And I will see y'all next weekend, because we're going to have an eventful weekend next weekend. This weekend was a good weekend, though. I cannot lie. Love y'all. Bye. You